Okay, so the last page of the notes, just a little bit of interval notation practice. So interval notation is different than what you may have learned. This is just set notation. X is greater than 4, and we want to use interval notation in this class. So we might want to graph this first. So X is greater than 4 looks like there's a 4 there, and there's 4 is not greater than 4, so we would put an open circle there, and then all the numbers greater than 4 are to the right of 4. So that's what the number line looks like. And interval notation is really supposed to mimic a number line without having to draw a number line. So that open hole is going to show up as a parentheses, and we're talking all the numbers from 4 to infinity, not including 4. So that's interval notation for X is greater than 4. All right, this one is saying that X is between 3 and 9. All the numbers between 3 and 9, and we're including 3 but not 9. So the graph of this, you'd have a 3 and a 9, and you would have a colored circle on the 3 but an open hole on the 9, and all the numbers in between. And so again, interval notation is meant to mimic the number line. So this would be bracket 3 to 9 parentheses. So 3, X is between 3 and 9. That's what it looks like in interval notation. Okay, now C is very important. This is going to happen a lot when we do domain. This is saying that X is not 5 or X is not 3. So how would we turn around and write that in interval notation? Well, the best thing to do is to look at the graph. Really, really important to understand that interval notation mimics the graph. So I'm going to put the key numbers down, -3 and then to the right 5. So there's all these numbers, and all I'm doing is writing down the key numbers. And if X is not equal to 5, I'm going to put an open hole there. And if X is not equal to 3, I'm going to put an open hole there. But what this is saying is that everything else is allowed. And so you get that number line. So what this looks like in interval notation is all the numbers to the left of -3 forever and ever and ever and ever, that's the parentheses negative infinity, and then to -3. And then we can include -3, and then we have this U for union, and then all the numbers from -3 to 5, but we can include -3 or 5, and then union, all the numbers from 5 to infinity, but we can't include 5, and of course we can't contain infinity. So this gets a little much, but you'll get used to it. So if you draw the number line, each of these little pieces of the interval match up with the solid lines in the graph, and so it's really important to remember that if you've got two things that it can't be, you're going to end up with three pieces of the interval, because we're hopping over -3 and we're hopping over 5, but everything else is included. All right, and then we get some pretty tricky ones here. X is not equal to -5, or X is not equal to 4, and X is greater than 1. So now we just get into the difference between or and and. And means that both things have to happen. So what would be a smart idea here would be to graph two separate number lines. First, we got -5 and 1 and 4. And then here, -5, 1 and 4. Okay, so if I graph X can't be -5 or X can't be 4, it looks like that graph we just did earlier. And then if I graph X is greater than 1, that looks like this, open hole and to the right. Now, because it says and, I only want the places where both of these statements are true. And the only place that both statements are true, it has to be greater than 1, and it can't be -5 or 4. So if we put both of these together, this right here is where it's true. So I'll do one final number line. And the reason that you have to do this is because some of this information kind of falls away as unimportant. So it starts being true right here, but can't color in 1 because it's not true here. X has to be greater than 1, so it can't be 1. But it can be anything greater than 1, but it can't be 4 because it said X can't be 4, so we have that. And that's our final graph. So this negative 5 stuff here just kind of fell on out. And then we use interval notation. So this would be 1, parentheses 1, comma 4, parentheses, union parentheses 4 to infinity. So sometimes it really gets tricky. You have to graph them both, and means that both of them have to be true. And so if it has to be greater than 1, it doesn't really matter that it can't be negative 5. So you have to sort of think it through there. All right, and then the last one, same thing, except it's an or. So I'll graph them separately, and you can kind of see the difference between and or. And our final answer we'll put down here. Okay, so x is less than 3 means that all the numbers to the left of 3 but can't include 3. And x is greater than or equal to 6 would be colored in circle on 6 and to the right. And here's the difference between and or. Or just means that if it's a solution to one, then it's a solution to the other. So as long as it's less than 3 or x is greater than or equal to 6, it's a solution. So when you have an or, you basically just combine all your answers. So I'm going to collect all my x is less than 3 answers. I'm going to collect all my x is greater than or equal to 6 answers, and that's the number line. But remember, we're practicing interval notation. So what this would be in interval notation would be negative infinity to 3 parentheses union bracket 6 to infinity. So that was a quick review on interval notation.